water under the willow sits a lone ranger minding the willow. He and his wife once lived happily, planted a seed that grew through the reeds.
This elegant, long, beautiful necklace was named after my sister Rebekah, who was asking if I could make her a long necklace, and this is what I came up with. She is actually the model in the video here, so for this project you'll need silver-lined hex-cut seed beads, transparent white bugle beads, 6mm white pearl beads, small silver cone beads, 6mm faceted glass beads, 3/4 inch eye pins, 4mm jump rings, 6mm soldered closed jump rings, 1mm crimp beads, 3mm crimp covers, 0.019 inch in diameter beading wire and pearl white, fine cable chain, 2 pairs of pliers, these are to open and close jump rings, round nose pliers, wire cutters, crimping pliers, and a ruler. So let's move on to making the necklace. So slide on a pearl bead on an eye pin, form a loop, and then trim the excess wire. Make 6 more of these bead units. Now cut a 3.5 inch length of cable chain. You need to cut 8 more of these lengths. Now open a loop on a bead unit, and then attach 1 length of your chain. Close the loop, and then open the loop on the other side of the bead unit, and attach another length of chain. Okay, your goal is to make a beaded chain that has 3 bead units and 4 chain lengths, and then another beaded chain that has 4 bead units and 5 chain lengths. You want the beaded units separated by the chain lengths. Now time to connect the 2 beaded chains. So open a jump ring and then attach the soldered closed jump ring, and then one end of the beaded chain. Right now it doesn't matter which beaded chain. Now open another jump ring, and then attach a soldered closed jump ring, as well as the other end of the beaded chain. So now one of your beaded chains should now have a soldered closed jump ring on either end. Open another 4mm jump ring, and attach the other beaded chain along with one of the soldered closed jump rings. Basically, you are connecting both beaded chains using the soldered closed jump ring. Do the same with the last jump ring. Cut a length of beading wire to about 16 inches. Slide on a crimp bead and one of the soldered closed jump rings. Slide the wire back through the crimp. This makes a loop around the soldered closed jump ring. and then secure the crimp in place using crimping pliers. By the way, for your reference, the shorter length of beaded chain is the front portion of the necklace. String on the following beads. 5 buccal beads and a 6mm faceted bead. You can cover the excess wire by sliding the buccal beads over it. Now repeat this design about 8 more times. Slide on a crimp bead and the other soldered closed jump ring. Then slide the wire back through the crimp bead. Secure the crimp, and then thread the excess wire through a few bugle beads and trim the excess wire close to the beads. Cut a 14-inch length of beading wire. Slide on a crimp bead and one of the soldered closed jump rings. Slide the wire back through the crimp. Secure the crimp in place. Okay, so this time we want to trim the excess wire very close to the crimp bead. I'm using side cutters here rather than my regular wire cutters because I can get close to the crimp bead. Now pop on a crimp cover. And secure it in place. Slide on a crimp bead. Measure 2 inches away from the last crimp. Secure the crimp in place. Sometimes when crimping only one strand of wire, the crimp gets loose. To avoid this, make sure to secure the crimp very securely. I do this by using the end of my crimping pliers. Okay, string on a hex cut bead, a silver cone bead, and another hex cut bead, and then a crimp bead. Slide all the beads down to the secured crimp, and then secure the crimp in place. Repeat the beaded design 3 more times, each with 2-inch spacings. Then it's time to finish off. So slide on a crimp bead and slide through the other soldered closed jump ring. Then thread the wire back through the crimp. And position the crimp so the beaded design and the soldered closed jump ring are 2 inches apart. Secure the crimp and then trim the excess wire. Pop on a crimp cover and secure it in place.
Down by the water, under the willow, sits a lone ranger. Once lived happily. seed that grew through the reeds. Summers and winters through snowy Decembers, sat by the water, close to the embers, missing out the lives that they once had before. I wouldn't leave you, I would hold you.
Today we're doing the Crafters Confidential Tag, and the first half of this video will be on her channel.